Oh my god.
It's not even like the sun is starting to rise yet. It's pitch black still. This is insane.
I'm almost there, but there's not a lot of time. This morning's prayer starts at 5:30. I don't even know if there's gonna be time for introductions. I think I'm just gonna be thrown into morning prayer and then talk to them after. So we'll see how this goes.
Light right there.
That's where we're going. Okay, before we go in, let me explain just a little bit more. Buddhism is practiced by over 500 million people worldwide, a majority of which are in Asia, leaving many of us who grew up in the West with less exposure to the true practices and teachings of Buddhism. And although Buddhism is practiced across America, there are only 3 Peace Pagodas in the entire country. After meeting Junsun, I explained to her my story, where she agreed to let me join her for a weekend to document her lifestyle and celebrate the upcoming festival of Hanamatsu.
Hanamatsuri.
Yeah, that. Which is the celebration of the Buddha's birthday. Now that you're all caught up, let's head in.
Every monument on the property, and we're giving prayer. Now we're going up to the Peace Pagoda.
Genjo-san is
Zen
monk.
Yeah.
From different order. But he loves here. He comes from far away.
Where is he from?
Pennsylvania. This is just walking and pray for peace. So all this walking process, I met so many different people. So what's happening when you are walking, you see so many different people show up. People asking, what you doing, you know, if you are not peace walk? So I say, I make peace pagoda. Some people say, sounds interesting, I help you. We digging foundation by hand. And when we are digging, people say, oh, I have more material for you. So it's not from pick up material, like from people's real pure heart, giving hand, giving time.
I think it'd be amazing to know how many people's hands were in building this place.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Thousands, huh?
One day, a big truck show up and looks like a Trump supporter type of people show up.
Yeah.
He said, I saw you guys every day walking same road, and I start worry about you guys thirsty, no water, so I brought water for you.
Yeah.
It's so amazing, so much kind people. Each people has a beautiful heart.
Yeah.
We couldn't see because we are so isolated world, isolated community.
Yeah.
But all different kind people, they are Trump supporter type of people, young and old, and this. It's so much open up heart. So I more realize myself that everybody has sacredness in the heart. So I keep walking because I have a foot.
Yeah. Thank you guys for the stories.
Yep. Moving stones out of the way.
We're trying to get it about this deep. So we'll put the post and then we'll pour some concrete.
So he was telling me when she first started building this Peace Pagoda. Wow. She started with a big serving spoon. Probably like the size of the shovel, just digging the foundation all by herself. So right now we're just preparing for tomorrow's flower festival, where they're celebrating Buddha's birthday. What Junsun told me was that Buddha was born from a garden, and because of that, everybody brings a ton of flowers to celebrate.
Ooh, red tail. That's a good sign.
What is it?
The red tail. Red tail off right there.
Oh.
She flew right over. Woo!
So right now I'm getting kindling together to make a fire. Not really sure what for, but I think it's to heat this big pot of water. We're getting it going. This guy's telling me this crazy story that when they were first building that Peace Pagoda, the big temple out there, Junsun, the Buddhist nun here, she started building it with just a spoon. He was saying that word spread. And a guy came out here to see what she was doing and brought an entire construction crew out the next day and started helping her excavate. You might have been able to figure this out by the conversation earlier, but basically that entire temple was built. No money was spent. It was just people coming and helping. Gotta go get some more kindling for it. I just think the craziest part of that story is that she just knew it was gonna be built. They talk a lot about like faith here and just trusting that it'll work out. I just figured out it's a hot tub. This is a hot tub. Coming here, I have nothing to do but be present. Nothing to do but watch this hawk fly around.
Some good gloves on. Oh my gosh. I never picked up a bird before. She's gonna tear my face off.
This is right.
Okay, I'll go around the other side, Junsun.
I can't believe it was that easy.
Yeah, she's hurt. She's real sanctuary? Gentle. There's a bird sanctuary right up the road.
Oh.
We called the number that you told us to and they didn't answer. Like nobody even picked up the phone.
Okay, all right, that's better. You have it? Oh, you already got it? Ooh. Okay, I don't want you to get hurt. I'm not gonna hurt you. See, his wings are good. He doesn't look bad. If the worst comes to worst, and this poor little guy turns out to be non-releasable, bring it here.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Because the only other option is to have him euthanized.
No.
No, I mean it.
No.
Okay. Gets to a point, they know. Right? You know.
You know.
So now we'll just put him here. It's better he's here.
Yeah,
and let him, you know, just let him relax, you know, because he could very well have been hit. You know, but anyway, like I say, I was with the birds, and you know, I paid my dues over the years. I've been doing this for over 50 years. I started doing this right after I got out of the army. You know, and I was a psychological mess. I don't want you to think you're talking to a lunatic, but I just want to come across with the idea that this was meant to be what I'm doing. When I got home, we were treated like garbage. You know, people were throwing trash at us. I was called a killer and all this shit. And it was just the opposite. I was a healer.
You are a healer.
Anyway, I don't want to get into the war stories, but what I'm trying to get you across is, you know, all of a sudden, something clicked.
Yeah.
And I started, you know, because I was suffering from PTSD. I still do. But, you know, the positive,
yes.
You know, if you can look to the good side, and never mind all the bullshit. You know,
we were just talking about that this morning.
You have to.
We were just talking about that.
Right. It doesn't matter how old you are, you know, but I know why I'm here. I'm here for a purpose. I consider myself one of the luckiest men in the world. I mean it. But I'm just saying, you know, you have to keep that positive energy and keep pushing and pushing and pushing.
Yeah.
And then things suddenly, boom, they come. My babies! Oh, my babies. I want to show you two more of my babies. The big one, that's Thor. They're so friendly. Mitch is from Afghanistan. Uh-huh. This guy deliberately shot it, and then our boys came along, the Navy SEALs. They took Mitch with them. And they took the bird, and everything was cool. So finally what happened was we had to figure out where the hell to go with this bird because he's non-releasable. Part of his wing was shot off. So they called all over the freaking planet, and I said, yeah, sure, no problem. President Obama gave them permission to bring him here.
Some kitchen help.
I'm sharing all this crap that's in my head right now, but I'll tell you this. When I was about 12 years old, I had a vision. And for some reason, I couldn't move. I was like sort of paralyzed and so forth. Yeah. And then all of a sudden, I'm looking up, and I see a big blue sky. And in that blue sky, I see thousands of birds flying over my head, saying my name.
Wow.
Now that was when I was 12. I had never had an inkling about doing something like this with animals, whatever. What I'm trying to say is, if you follow the path within, believe in yourself, you know, put aside all the bullshit and just say to yourself, okay, what are we gonna do?
That was actually crazy. The hawk we were talking about all morning.
That's a hawk right there?
Oh.
That's a good sign.
Nothing to do but watch this hawk fly around.
Just happened to get injured and we brought it to a bird sanctuary where we met this guy who was talking about the same messages of putting good out into the world and watching what comes back. That just blows my mind. But there's a couple hours till the sun sets and I'm pretty tired. So I think I'm just gonna turn the cameras off for a couple hours, get to know everybody a little bit more, and then head to bed.
Here we go.
We're celebrating Buddha's birthday today, so we're getting ready for the flower festival. People are gonna be here in a couple hours, so we just gotta get the final touches together.
So the monks are walking out right now to go over to the pagoda and start the ceremony.
Fuji Guruji, who's kind of the head of their order, met Gandhi and kind of broke off then from his sect of Buddhism a little bit to not be in one particular place, to walk and drum, to be on the streets with people. Like the church, we go there on Sunday.
Yeah.
Or wherever you know. But the philosophy of being out with people is very humbling.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I didn't realize that that's like part of...
That's all they do.
Wow.
I mean, they have their temple and they say
that. Yeah.
And right now they're an older group. I'm going to say maybe only 100 in the whole country. But no, that is Nipponzai Mahoji. That's their order.
Yeah.
And that's what they do. They're very different from... So they're a little different than regular.
Yeah.
The walking is practice.
Wow. They all believe different things, but it's like...
The same thing.
It's this. It's at its core. Yeah.
We just wrapped up the festival. We're just gonna clean up now. Got an afternoon prayer, and then I think my time here is coming to an end. You invest your life in these
bodies, we will live in these bodies. I just had a really real moment for like 2 hours and just turned the cameras off and really just took this place all in, and I think that's when I learned the most. But it's like I didn't have a big spiritual awakening, I just feel more appreciative. And I think that shows what being giving can do.